Hello guys, this is Revath from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting news in Tech News 162. Motorola S20 and S20 Fusion are launching in India on August 17th. Motorola S20 Fusion is said to be a rebranded version of the Moto S20 Lite but with the MediaTek Dimensity 800U chipset instead of Dimensity 720. Motorola S20 will be available via Flipkart online. IQ 8 series is launching in China on August 17th. IQ 8 series will come with 120W fast charging, triple camera and a 120Hz AMOLED display. IQ 8 Pro price is said to be 5,299 Chinese Rial, that is around 60,700 rupees. Realme GT 5G, Realme GT Master Edition phones and a Realme Book Slim are set to launch in India on August 18th through a virtual event. Realme GT series will include a Realme GT 5G, Realme GT Explorer Master Edition and looks like Realme GT Master Edition will be launched as well. Realme Book Slim will be the first laptop which is offering from the company. And Realme has confirmed in China that Realme Book is set to launch on August 18th. This laptop teaser to feature a 2K display with 3:2 aspect ratio. Live shots of the laptop has also been leaked online suggesting the Realme Book's design and key features. Ola Electric on Sunday launched its S1 and S1 Pro electric scooters at ₹99,000 and ₹1.29 lakhs. It is available in 10 colors in satin, matte and glossy finishes. The S1 Pro variant is stepping new industry benchmarks with a range of 181 km, acceleration of 0 to 40 km per hour in 3 seconds and a top speed of 115 km per hour. It has a 3.97 kW of battery capacity, more than 30% higher than its next closest electric vehicle and the most powerful motors in the category with 8.5 kW of peak power. Ola S1 also comes with a proprietary battery management system which works actively to monitor the battery for optimal durability, performance, range and safety. Simple Energy, a Bengaluru-based electric vehicle startup, today launches first ever product in the market, Simple One electric scooter at a starting price of 1,09,999 Indian rupees. This electric scooter will be available in 75 cities in 13 states in the next couple of months. The highlight of the latest offering in the electric scooter segment is its range, claimed to be massive near 240 km in a single charge. And this scooter offers various ride modes that will affect the achievable range depending on the top of the speed, which is claimed at 105 km. Per hour. It is powered by a 4.8 kilowatt battery pack which is portable and weighs up to 7 kgs. And it is promising a real-world range of 203 km in eco mode and 236 km in ideal conditions. TikTok will stop sending push notifications to users 13 to 15 years old after 9 PM and after 10 PM for 16 and 17 years old. The main reason is being a desire to limit the pressure to interact at least after a certain hour to these age groups, which some research has shown are a lot of more susceptible to the modern pressure of social networks than adults. TikTok is also tightening its private messaging restrictions, expanding on the already existing PM ban on users under 16 years of age. Accounts marked 16 and 17 will now by default having their private messaging disabled and will require manually enabling in the account settings. A patent filed by Apple suggests that future MacBooks could come with an Apple Pencil along with a compartment to store it above the keyboard. The new concept design replaced a large touch bar with a smaller one on the right side while using an extra real estate to house an Apple Pencil. Yanko Design has also created a few concept images and how the new design could look like when implemented in a MacBook Pro. Micromax launched the IN2B entry-level smartphones with Unisoc T610 chipset offering decent specifications in budget. It is the first smartphone to launch with the chipset in India, but now Unisoc Executive Vice President has revealed that more phones with T610 technology will enter India. Unisoc has already collaborated with several Indian and Chinese smartphone manufacturers which are expected to launch new phones in the coming months. Unisoc collaborated with Realme, Micromax and Motorola to bring the Unisoc T610 mobile phones to India. Among these brands, Micromax has already released the IN2B smartphone with T610. We can expect Realme and Motorola to launch T610 powered phones in India very soon. Google Stadia was adding a new update that included touchscreen controls and Android app TV support. Users can now play games on Stadia using the proprietary controller, third-party controllers, a mouse and a keyboard, and now touchscreen controllers. This update added the ability to use touchscreen controllers on games when played on devices such as phone or tablet. The only issue was that there were no games that made use of these controls, but things looks to be changing as the first touchscreen game has been announced. Humankind and developed by Amplitude Studios, the game game launches out since Stadia on August 17th. This game will implement Direct Touch, which detects multi-touch inputs. Actions like gestures, etc. can now be converted to controllers on games. You can check out the image on the screen to find more about the controllers and how they function in the game. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.